did not take any questions from reporters. Now, coming up on Action News at 6, we hear more from Vice President Mike Pence, and we also learn how these tax cuts benefited Riewoldt and Son. We'll have that coming up. Right now, we're in Rochester. Simon Chowdhury for the Now Detroit.
All right, thank you so much, Simon. We are following breaking news right now with the search in the Detroit River. The Coast Guard, the Harbor Master, and the Detroit Fire Department are all searching near the 8,000 block of East Jefferson. They're following reports that someone saw a body in the water. So far, investigators are not confirming that, but they are out there searching. If we get any information, we'll certainly pass it on to you. All right, let's take a look outside right now. We are tracking some possible rain coming our way as we take a live look at Ann Arbor and Mount Clemens. Meteorologist Kevin Jeans can tell you how soon it could get wet out there. Kevin.
Hey, Carolyn. Yeah, overnight tonight and really tomorrow morning and into tomorrow afternoon, we get a couple of chances of some rain. But for the most part, what you're seeing here out in northwestern Michigan is falling apart as it's moving into more stabilized air, stable air across southeastern Michigan. So what we will see for the next several hours, more high clouds moving in. So the clouds increasing. A couple of showers west of Saginaw right now, so there could maybe be a light shower sprinkled around Saginaw across the Felton. But most of us avoid the rain tonight, so Friday night plan should be dry. It's just warm right now, temperatures in the 80s. Chance of rain, though, after midnight and then through tomorrow morning. Meanwhile, heat advisories already for the weekend. That's out to our west, though, so we don't have any advisories yet for us, but it will be hot through this weekend. We're talking the 80s and 90s tomorrow and Sunday. We'll look exactly at the weekend numbers coming up.
It's sizzling. Thank you so much, Kevin. All right, take a good look at this video. Detroit police want to talk to this man right here about a deadly shooting. He was seen entering the Valero gas station on East 7 Mile near Gratiot last night. Moments later, police say there was an attempted robbery at that location. A 27-year-old man from Detroit was shot multiple times in the head and in the neck and later died. Investigators believe this man could help them solve the case. If you recognize him, please call Detroit police. Well, MSU's interim president, John Engler, is refusing to resign despite growing calls for him to do so. We want to hear from you. Should John Engler step down as MSU's president, yes or no? The imbalance.